anniversary of with Desi and Lucille. Tonight we're going to have another anniversary. This is the anniversary of a play, the tremendous musical smash hit on Broadway, Fanny, because it was just a year ago that we presented it. We were permitted to present it on this stage. And tonight we're going to give you a resume of it with Josh Logan acting as our interlocutor. Now in this first scene, which is in the early dawn at Marseille, this boy, Marius, who wants to go to sea, is called to the waterfront to look at a big schooner that's sailing in. And the one who calls him is a weird waterfront character who's been nicknamed in Marseille, the Admiral. Here is the opening scene.
Marius!
What is it, Admiral?
Look what's just come into the harbor. A square rigger. I didn't know there were any left in the world. Look at the sun on those sails. Pink. I want to be on that ship. Oh, I want to be on that ship.
I see a silver bird that streaks the sky. And off we fly, my heart and I. My restless heart and I see a cloud dance by and fade from view. There we go to, my heart and I. My restless heart and I say to each new ship that sails the bay, are you the one it will be? Have you come at last this golden day?
Ezio Pinza and Walter Slezak and the little Henderson girl and the other stars of Fanny, which is now completing its first spectacular year on Broadway. I'd like you to meet one of the men who is responsible for it, the Pulitzer Prize winner, Josh Logan. So let's have a very big hand for this distinguished director. Josh, now that was the opening scene, as I recall it, down in Philadelphia. But there are so many other scenes in there. What would you think would be some of the other highlights of Fanny?
Well, of course, one of the great highlights and one of the most famous scenes is the one that has been made famous by our little Turkish dancing girl, Necla Ateş. Now, in order to show you how we get into the scene, I just would like to say that the boy that was singing is Jack Washburn, who plays the part of Marius, who is the love interest, the leading man of our show. And he is in love with a little shellfish vendor named Fanny. But he has a secret desire that you've just heard to go to sea. He keeps this secret from his girl and from his father, Cesar, who is played by Ezio Pinza, and whom we'll see in a few minutes. Now, in order to keep this secret, he has to make arrangements to get on this great sailing ship, the Malazie, which is going around the world for 5 years, by meeting the second mate of the Malazie in an out-of-the-way place that his father and his girl would never go to. So he goes to the sort of evil side of the city, to a low waterfront dive known as Hakim's Cellar.
first on the magazine. I'd rather give her a first. Maybe that can be arranged. I'll do.
Never forgotten since I saw it was opening down in Philadelphia is that wonderfully delicate scene. You know, it's been 2 years now since Marius has gone to sea.
Oh, yeah.
He returns on Fanny's birthday.
Well, it's not Fanny's birthday, but it is
the
a
baby's
birthday. The baby's birthday, that's right. It is a famous scene. I know whether you like it. We all like it. As a matter of fact, it's the reason that we did the show, practically. This is a great scene in French literature, and although we have changed this great French play into an American musical show, this scene always remains one of the outstanding scenes of our show. It takes place about the middle of the show. And there's one character that I have not told you about, which is a rich sailmaker who lives quite in the same community, named Panisse. And his name, he's not only... Panisse is already beginning to get ready. This rich sailmaker is played by Walter Slaza. And he has had his eye on Fanny for many years, knowing that Marius wanted to go to sea, knowing Marius' secret. And this is a scene a year after he has been able to persuade Fanny to marry him. Fanny is now married to Panisse. And it is the first year's anniversary. It is the first birthday of Fanny's child, Cesario.
I am just drunk enough to say, Panisse, and mind you, I would not say it if I was sober. And before I say it, I want to thank you for the champagne that got me drunk enough to say it. You are a smug man, Panisse.
Smug? Smug doesn't remotely convey what I am. I'm arrogant. I'm conceited. I'm Alexander the Great and Napoleon rolled into one. And why shouldn't I be? I have Fanny. Fanny, I've had just as much champagne as this Castafie. More, because before the party I slipped back into the nursery, I had a bottle with Cesario. While he was having his formula, I had mine. To my wife, who walks so gently through my thoughts all day long, clean and fresh and white, soft and strong, makes me feel that there is nothing I can't do if I try, with my wife and son standing by. She may scold, say I eat too much, find some fault, give free advice. But a meal needs that added touch of salt and spice to be extra nice. Words won't do. There's so much I must thank her for. Where to start? How am I to say from the heart what I owe? To my critic, my partner, the flavor of my life, to my wife. Fanny, a famous Greek philosopher once said, a wife is someone who will stick by you through all the troubles you would not have had had you not married her. But I don't agree with him. Because every night before I fall asleep, and every morning when I wake up, I raise an invisible glass to the sunlight that brightens the autumn of my life. To my wife. Hello, Fanny. I'll be back in a few hours. I thought I'd drop by and say hello. How are you, Fanny?
I'm all right.
And my niece? You must be very happy.
Yes.
Well, then it's all happened for the best. It's very nice here. This is a big house. Dining room? Well, what room is that?
Oh, well, that's just a little extra bedroom.
Well, that must be the baby's room. How old is your baby?
Oh, he's just a baby.
Why didn't you ever write to me about him?
You never wrote to me.
I wrote 5 or 6 letters, but I tore them all up.
Why?
Well, you were happily married to Panice, and that didn't take very long, did it? 2 months after I sailed.
Go now, Marius. Whatever you can say now can be of no use.
Why did you marry Panice so quickly?
Oh, go away, Marius.
Oh, Fanny, I left with such high hopes. And then...
Oh, don't, Marius. Don't say it.
I told you, and now forget it. Unless you have to say it. Unless you have to say it.
Now then, children. Panice is a very decent fellow, and he's not here. Don't make him look ridiculous in front of his family furniture. That suit? Your old friend the Admiral told me you were here.
Father?
Yes?
Why didn't you ever tell me about the child?
What child? Somebody have a child?
He knows his arm.
Oh, that child.
Father?
Yes?
It's very good to see you again. But right at this moment, I beg you to leave us alone.
No. During the absence of her husband, you have nothing to do in the home of Madame Panice. You are coming with me.
I'm staying here.
Oh, no, you're not. There have been all kinds of people in our family. Idiots, pirates, customs inspectors, and even stubborn old bullies like your father. But there have never been any rats. Are you coming?
No.
Then I am not going. Oh, we just have a nice conversation. What shall we talk about? I see by the papers that the King of Montenegro arrived in Paris with 26 members of his household. Purpose of visit? To get his glasses fixed.
The door.
Phineas, you haven't missed your train again.
I didn't miss it. I let it go. I ran into Dr. Figaro and he told me that this hoop... Marius.
He is here only for a few hours.
That all depends, Father.
Depends on what?
It depends on you. And it depends on Fanny.
Fanny's my wife. And the mother of my son. For a long time now, I've been trying to go to Paris on business. Haven't I, Cesar? I missed every train. Because every time I put my foot on the platform, I'd say, this is the night Marius is coming back. What if he tries to take everything away from me? For 2 years, I've been preparing my answers. And now that I see you standing there so brown and tanned, I forget what I was going to say. Perhaps I'm in the way.
Oh, no, Penny.
Yes, perhaps I'm in the way. And the most gracious thing for me to do would be to go out and drown myself by accident. And believe me, Fanny, if it would assure your happiness, I might even do that. Only if I'm dead, I won't see the little one anymore. So I absolutely refuse to drown myself.
Nobody asked you to.
I asked myself, and I refuse. Fanny, if you want to leave me and go away with this lean young man, what happens to the child? The child? The child? Why don't you ask me for my eyes, for my heart, for my liver, for my spleen? No, Marius. You will never get the little one. Never. Marius, you are young, you can have other children. But this child is my first child, it's my last. Look, Marius, if he were an ordinary child like the children you see in the park, but this child is so unique, he's so special. Cesar, tell him, please.
Marius, he's right about that. You were a very beautiful child, but this one...
He coughed.
He coughed?
I didn't hear anything.
No, nobody hears him. But I hear him.
Phineas is a very generous and clever fellow who says he might give up the woman, but he will keep the child. Because he knows that without the child, the woman won't go. Is that fair?
Of course it's fair. Because Phineas is his father.
Who is the father? The one who gives life or the one who buys the bibs?
The father is the one who loves.
When the baby arrived, the way they found, now he is 23. What are they made of, those extra pounds? What can they be? 15 pounds of love they are, 15 solid pounds. 15 pounds of caring and sharing and love. Love is a very light thing. Love is so fragile and frail. You cannot hold it here in your hand or wait on a scale. Cigarette smoke, that's all it is. Whiskey and curling around. Oh, it takes a lot of love to make a pound. Fanny gave Hermes. I slipped in an ounce or two. But the big weight, the bulk, Fanny, and yet, love is a very light thing, light as a song in the air. How do you start to feel of a heart? How many ounces there? Dragonfly wings, that's all it is, whispering by with no sound. Oh, it takes a lot of love to make a How many of those 15 pounds came from you, my son? How many?
There's only one thing left for me to do. And that is to go away. Goodbye, Father. Goodbye, Fanny.
Marius, I want you to know something. And since your father is here and can protect us from each other, I'm going to tell you. Only you, long as I may live.
My son, will you miss your train?
I wish I were in Panis's shoes. When he misses his train, he can come home.
Don't blame Fanny for this. Pity her. Here's a girl with no heart to give. Worth every tear I'll cry, Fanny.
Fanny, in its first year on Broadway, has done $3 million worth of business. Great, that was greater than South Pacific, wasn't it?
That's the greatest in the history of show business.
Greatest in the history of show business. But, of course, it doesn't finish that way. He didn't get this Pulitzer Prize for nothing. He's a very cunning writer, this Josh. Doesn't finish very happily, but just how it works out, you'll have to find out for yourself. Now, Josh, a lot of these out-of-towners here tonight asked me, they said, how can they get tickets for a show like Fanny?
The best way when you're out of town is to write to the box office of the Majestic Theater and tell them the night you want to see it, and they will send you the tickets in the mail. Or if you're in New York, go to the box office and buy the tickets there. And that's the way that you can find out how Fanny gets married.
Just as simple as that. Thank you, Lehman Engel, for your great job. And how about a very big hand for Josh Logan and all of his associates.
Lesser's The Most Happy Fellow, and stars Robert Weedy with Joe Sullivan, Susan Johnson, Mona Pauley, and Shorty Long. Because of our past friendship with Frank Lesser, who gave us Guys and Dolls and other great hits, we were able to present on our stage tonight for the very first time on TV, actual scenes sung by the actual stars of The Most Happy Fellow. Now, the story is the story of an aging immigrant farmer in California who has, well, I guess you could say he'd tricked a young waitress into a mail-order marriage by sending her not his own photo, but a photo of a young and handsome man. Now, at the opening of the second act, which you're about to see, the girl arrives, this young waitress, to find that he has been badly injured in an accident. So, recognizing the fraud that he's practiced on her, he marries him anyway out of pity. Now, you're about to see their first meeting since the wedding. Action, camera, curtains.
You mad at me? I send you wrong fella's pitch. If I was send you my pitch, you'd no come here, no? I'm sorry about the pitch.
Picture.
Picture? Oh, we friends now, huh? We start all over again. I'm gonna meet you for the first time.
Hello.
Well, when you meet somebody for the first time, there are special things you're supposed to say.
can you walk
Thank
better?
You so much, I feel fine.
Thank you so much, I'm a feel fine.
Happy to make your acquaintance.
Acquaintance.
And let me say the pleasure is mine.
She sure is poor.
Happy to make your acquaintance. Now won't you please say likewise?
Look-wise.
No, likewise.
Oh, likewise.
No, likewise.
Oh, likewise. Surprise!
Yeah. What happened? Why is she here?
Well, I sent for her. I give her a job festing the levels on my grip box.
No walking. It's in my contract.
That's all right. To sit down all the day.
All day.
Oh, gosh, am I glad to see you.
Oh, and me, you.
Hey, that's a new outfit.
Oh, you like it?
What did you do to your hair?
I rinsed it in the Friday special.
Hey, you got the old friend to keep you company now. Introduce me.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is Tony.
How are you?
How I am? Happy to make you acquaintance.
Feeling better after the accident?
Thank you so much. I'm a feel fine.
Well, it's certainly nice to meet you.
Happy to make you acquaintance.
It's a pleasure.
And let me say the pleasure. She's mine.
He's new.
How do you do? Pleased to know you.
And so polite, too.
And my English is poor.
Your English suits me fine.
Happy to make you acquaintance. And then I'm going to...
Now, won't you please say likewise?
It looky wise.
No, likewise.
Oh, likewise.
No, likewise.
Oh, likewise. Oh, Marie. That's my sister, Marie.
Oh, well, I'm happy to make your acquaintance.
She catch on quick, too, huh?
I'll take you into the house.
Thanks, I'll get cleaned up. See you later.
Tell me something.
Oh, yeah.
Why did you send for Cleo?
Well, I was thinking maybe you're lonesome.
Oh?
So? I sent for your friend you was telling me about.
You know something? I'm not so lonesome. I guess I like it here.
That's nice.
You know something else?
Well.
You're a nice, kind man.
How do you?